Welcome to Shift's Weight Loss Challenge. Today, we're going to talk about excessive cardio and how it prevents you from losing weight. Now, ask anyone who is new into the fitness scene about how you can lose weight and they will tell you to do more cardio. And then you go and ask people who have been working out for years on how to lose weight and they will also tell you that go and do more cardio. I see many people in the gym at treadmills, at elliptical machines, at the cross trainer, and they spend hours as they get themselves to do more cardio, thinking that they're burning more body fat. This thought process can really backfire and stop you from losing weight further. Let me explain. Our bodies are designed to match up to the environment and any stress that comes with it. Extreme cardio sessions over time teach the body how to be more efficient at producing energy to match up for the stressful cardio situations. In this case, the body tries to get rid of any excess weight that might slow you down from running. It might surprise you that all that excess weight doesn't really come from your fat. It actually comes from your muscle. The body tries to get rid of muscle as it is heavy and it is not needed for you to run faster or longer. It also has to be warmed up and cooled down, which results in poor efficiency. We know that having more muscles can help you lose fat, as muscle requires more calories to maintain itself and to be able to tap into those fat stores to use the calories. Muscle tissue has also the ability to mobilize fat even when you're not moving. That means you cannot burn fat while watching TV. Now, we've got a problem. The cardio that you thought is burning your fat is actually burning your muscle, and losing muscle is reducing your ability to burn more body fat. This becomes a vicious cycle that many performance-based athletes and individuals go through. Now, while your body is burning more muscle to be more efficient, it also stores energy to be used as fuel source when you are on an endless cardio workout. That energy is called body fat. Yes, it is true. As this process happens in the body also turns down many anabolic hormones such as growth hormone and testosterone, which impact your recovery. And lowering these hormones can increase your chances of injury. So my advice to you is to cut down on all long and boring cardio sessions and try using short high intensity cardio sessions, also called as HIIT or high intensity interval training, which is shown in multiple studies to be more effective in burning fat and takes very less time. There you go, that's a good hack. Now you can save time, burn fat, and lose less energy.